City from Switzerland, and today we're going to talk about pens, more specifically about EDC or tactical pens, and about this pen here in particular, because this is a pen that really impressed me and that I think needs a little bit more recognition in the EDC gear community. But let's take a look at the pens that I had so far. So here we have the very well-known Fisher Space Pen on this side. We have a bunch of different models because they are very inexpensive and just great compact EDC pens, and then you can just open them up and you have a full-sized pen there. This is the original version in the fully chromed look with the nice clip right there. And then there are a bunch of different models. I have here a treated brass version, so this one will not develop a patina, and you have these nice knurling all around there. Other than that, it's the same pen. And then I also have a raw brass pen here that will actually develop a patina, but this is the newest out of these pens, so it has not actually developed a patina. Then we have here one of my most used pens, which is the KID 50 cal bolt action pen from Boker, and this is the pen that I really like to carry because of its bolt action mechanism and its nice compact overall size. But this one is a little bit battle worn, and also the clip broke off, and I grew a little bit tired of the micarta pattern here on the handle, so I wanted to get something new. And this one here is a very special pen because it is a gift from my girlfriend, and this is just a very, very gorgeous pen, the Niala pen from Lionsteel. A great feat of machining with some gorgeous, very dense twist damasteel. Here is a barrel sleeve over the full titanium pen here, and also has a nice mechanism with the twisty here in the back. But now let's take a look at this pen right here, which is a very cool bolt action pen that also is size-wise very close to the KID 50 cal pen here, a little bit slimmer, and also has a much improved clip in my opinion. This is also one of the big selling points, the very cool deep carry clip here. But this pen is called MiniPen, and it is designed by Peter Döring, which is a German gold and bladesmith, and also his company is called Gold and Blade Forge. Here you can see his card. It is in German, of course, so here you can see Gold und Messerschmiede.de. So that is his company, and he designs a lot of different stuff. He does blades, he also has different kinds of pen other than this one here. Then he does some spinners and pocket tops and all kinds of things, as well as beads. You can check that out on his website if you're interested. But I was very interested in this pen from the point on where I saw it in a video from a channel called Incognito, where he was at a show and showed the table of Peter Döring. So this one here is his bolt action mini pen, which is a full titanium machine pen. There are also different options available, like full copper or brass, and then you have also full titanium deep carry clip that you can anodize in different colors, as well as the whole pen. The pens actually are not made by hand, they are machined by Lionsteel in Italy, so the same guys that make the Niala pen right here. But the design comes from Peter Döring, and he did these limited run production pieces together with a German store. Here you can see their logo. You also can see their logo in the provided leather sheath. Now let's take a look at the specs of this pen and then talk a little bit about how this design came together. So we have an overall length here on this particular pen of 10.8 centimeters or 4.25 inches, and that is with one of Peter Döring's extenders attached, because you can see here the part where you can see this line here until the pocket clip starts is actually a part that you can remove from the pen and make it shorter. So it actually comes without the extender right here, and the extender adds 1.6 centimeters. So without that, it would be 9.2 centimeters or 3.6 inches for the whole pen. So a very, very compact pen. I opted to add one of these extenders because it fits my hand a little bit better. I can use it without the extender, but it is a little bit small if you use it a lot. But that is certainly a really cool modular system that he has going on here, and you can actually use multiple extenders if you want to have a longer pen. Then the weight of this pen you can check out right now. So we have a weight on this with one extender attached, as well as the pocket clip, of 39 grams or 1.4 ounces. So certainly not too heavy, a good substantial weight for a full titanium pen here. And also the machining that you can see here is done really, really well. Here you can see some improvement in the first design that he did on a screw cap pen that he developed out of a glass breaking punch that he had, and some people asked him to build a pen out of this original design. So he actually still has a screw cap pen that has a little bit more aggressive milling here, and he wanted to build a more EDC friendly version of that pen and came up here with the bolt action mechanism pen, as well as with a little bit less aggressive milling here in the front part, so it's very comfortable to write with this pen for a prolonged time. Of course, the bolt action mechanism is a great, great feature on this pen, and also something that really drew me to this one here, because I already had that on my KID here. And this is just a very nice and smooth bolt action mechanism. You can see that here, very, very effortless and just nice and smooth. Also a great placement. It's right where your thumb lands when you're holding the pen like this. Also, the clip that he has here is awesome, much improved over the pens I showed you before. Maybe the closest thing I have would be the clip here on the Fisher Space Pen Bullet, but most other clips have a higher carry clip, like here for example, the Niala pen, or the clip that the KID had. And this is just a very cool, really nicely working deep carry titanium clip, and you can see mine is anodized in a nice bronze color. That is some custom touches that Peter Döring offers. You can also see that my screw for the bolt action here is also anodized bronze, and I think that gives a very, very cool overall look to this pen. As for a cartridge, I can unscrew the tip right here, and then you can see that it has a quite short cartridge here. You have the Lamy M22, and of course the cartridge has to be that small because you have the bolt action mechanism not at the end of the pen, because there you have your extender. But the cartridge is very, very nice to write, nice and smooth. You have no hang-ups there, so I'm quite happy with the cartridge. But of course you have to change it out more often than a larger cartridge. One thing that I want you to notice here is also the nice quality of the threading that they have here on this pen. Everything here is done very nicely by Lionsteel. So really high quality pen that you look at here with the pen from Peter Döring. Then if you take a look at the back of the pen, you can see that the deep carry clip is secured by a large torque screw. And if you want to disassemble the pen or take off your extender, you just take a torque screwdriver and then open up the screw there. And then you can take out the large screw, take off the clip, and here you can also take a look at the machining on this pen. Just very nicely done. And the clip as well. Here on the inside you can also see some markings, Lionsteel and the name of the company that he worked together to bring this pen to market. And here you can see the logo of Peter Döring and his company. So really cool logo, very, very unique. And then you can twist off the extender as well here. And you can see here the machining, everything. And here you can see you can use multiples of these on the end of your pen to make it longer. And here you have the bare bones pen without any extender. And then you can just reattach the clip that runs on this little lip they created. Put it right on there, secure it in place, and then you are going to screw your clip screw here at the top right on. Secure it a little bit better with your screwdriver. It's a little bit hard here in front of the camera, but you can just secure it with the screwdriver. And then you have the original mini pen, and here you can see why it is called the mini pen, because it's a very, very compact EDC pen, so very easy to carry if you don't want to use an extender. And you still can write with that quite easily but I like to carry one of the extenders on there just for some prolonged use. But overall, I think it's a very cool modular design, and it's really nice that you have the option to slim it down like this and carry a very, very compact pen that should be absolutely easy to carry for everybody. So if you're interested in a pen like this, there is two ways you can go to get one of those pens. First off, you can get a pre-finished, pre-packaged one on the web store of Dirk Wanger, which is called Messer & Co. Or you can get one custom from Peter Döring, where you can get custom anodizing done and some other nice custom touches. You can also choose different materials for the extender, like copper or brass, so you can really make this pen your own. And then you're also getting this nice certificate of authenticity, where you can see the product name, material is of course titanium, then the custom touches that he has done, and here you can also see the serial number as well as the date when it was finished. So really cool there. And you also are getting this leather sheath, which is a cool little touch. Not one thing that I see myself using, because I just like how this poker clip here performs, and I like to just clip it in my pocket and I'm good to go, but certainly a nice additional piece there. And of course you're going to pay a little bit extra for custom touches like the anodizing right here, and of course for the extender, because it does not come with one of those. But overall, I think a very, very cool pen. I'm absolutely in love with this. It's just a thing that I had to have, and on pens that does not happen that often for me, but I really like the bolt action mechanism, and for me personally, this is the best bolt action pen I have seen or handled so far. Just a great compact overall size, awesome clip, great design, very comfortable to write with, nice cartridge there that writes very nice and continuously without any hang-ups. Extremely smooth bolt action mechanism. Another cool thing that I wanted to show you here is actually that the serial number is lasered inside there. Here you can see it, serial number 98, which is also a pretty cool little feature. But overall, I have to say, a great, great EDC pen. Certainly one you should take a look at if you're interested in a more higher-end pen. And of course, the price for a pen like this is also a big issue. But I think with a price of 139 euros without the extender, which is going to cost a little bit extra, as well as the anodizing, it is in the ballpark for a very high quality pen that is very nicely machined. So you are in the ballpark of a Niala pen right here, which is made from the same company. I think it certainly is a premium pen, so you have to pay a little bit more than for a regular pen there, but the quality is certainly there. And if you're interested in higher end pens, I would highly suggest that you check out the website of Peter Döring, which you can see here on this card at the bottom. He has some very, very cool stuff, also apart from pens. So I hope you liked this video. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun, and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.